lost the Camino de Santiago in Spain. And there were many experiences along the way that were life-shaping, basically, for me. But some of them were also very fun. And I can remember one time we arrived to a pilgrim hostel after we walked for, 25 kilometers during that day. And it was this very old medieval-type place that was actually almost sort of underground. And so my sister and my mother decided to go off to the supermarket and to get some food for us. And I was going to cook the dinner. And after a nice cold shower, because there was no hot water, it was raining, and I finally went out to try and go find them, couldn't find them, came back. An hour later, my mother and my sister showed up. It turns out they had walked the 3 kilometers all the way up the hill and then 3 kilometers back to bring the food. So we had a nice dinner and everything. Everybody laughed about the fact that they didn't have walked an extra 6 kilometers that day. But that evening, I got up at 3 in the morning from my bunk bed with the 50 other people that were staying in this tiny little place, and I had to go to the bathroom. And the bathroom was outside in a little bit farther away. And as I'm getting up, climbing down, sleeping in my bunk bed, trying to be quiet, my mother says, "Watch out for the sheep." And I said, "What?" I had no idea what she was talking about, but I figured, she's asleep. I don't know. So my sister goes, "Wait, I have to go to the bathroom too." So she came down, two of us walked out, we walked to the bathroom, and as I'm going, it's kind of dark, and we're looking through, trying to get there, and there's a big rock, and then I see this from other ways, and all of a sudden, the rock moves, and he got up, and the two of us jumped, and then I realized what my mother had said. She said, "Watch out for the sheep." There has